America need to be like this all day after that segment.
I want to do the jawbreaker.
Right. Well, we are celebrating the autumn season with some delicious desserts on the couch today.
And pastry chef Colleen Grapes from the Red Cat Restaurant is here to show us a couple of her favorites.
And she's not just showing us one, but two sweet treats. Welcome. Love, love the restaurant. So thank you for joining us here on the couch.
Good morning.
Thank you. So what are we going to get into today?
We have two specials here for you today. One is from the I Love Corn Cookbook, which is actually a little true and dear to my heart. A great friend of mine, Lisa Sky, actually came up with a book for the Dougie Center out in California.
Oh, that's nice.
So it's fantastic. 75% of the proceeds do go to
that
organization.
Significant number.
It is amazing.
Yeah.
It is absolutely amazing.
And delicious stuff, too. So what, what are we putting together?
Yes, actually, we're going to be putting that corn cake together. So it's a peach and rhubarb corn cake.
Okay.
And we also have a vanilla wafer Napoleon. We're doing little individual ones for you guys to try today.
Take us through the steps of the first one. Let's do the peach first.
We'll do the peach first. Yeah. So we have some little corn tarts that we have here today.
Okay.
Want me to cut the corn tarts?
That would be also corn cakes.
Corn cakes.
Well,
I'm the corn tarts.
Yeah. You're the corn
and coffee together. Is there any trick to this?
Nope, you're just going to cut it right
now.
Scare me when you do that.
Look at that.
Lisa's such a natural.
You want three of them?
That would be fantastic. I'm going to put out three plates for you guys as well.
Okay.
Be careful.
Put this one right here.
And this is from the book. This recipe is from the book called I Love Corn.
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
perfect.
Absolutely.
So we can see that. And that's the one that you said that happens.
Okay, corn cakes cut.
Awesome. Fantastic.
Corn cakes cut, Colleen.
So I'm ready to do. This is ready to go.
That is ready to go, so we can put actually a little dollop.
Okay. Here, I'll hold it and you do the dollop.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, dollops are hard to get right.
Yeah.
You know, we want to make sure that we don't dollop
do
too much.
That's a perfect dollop right there.
That is a world-class dollop.
No, that's a pro dollop.
That's
okay, you can make it happen.
You can always fix it by adding more.
What is? Wait a minute, I missed this. What is this? This is Cool Whip?
That's whipped cream.
I don't know what.
It's whipped cream. Usually for this recipe, I actually don't put any sweetener in the whipped cream.
Okay.
Really?
I kind of let all the ingredients speak for themselves. Everything else is sweet, so it balances out the sweetness.
When you're working with fruit, it's nice to be able to speak for all the love in the fruit.
Now, do I need to start cutting?
If we could cut up some peaches, that would be fantastic.
Oh, geez.
Now this, we get some
How do you want them cut? Just like sliced?
Oh gosh, that knife.
Stab it and then just. There you go.
Chef Colleen, when did you decide that you wanted to become a chef? Like, what made you so passionate about food?
Oh, boy. You know, I was grateful to know two of my great-grandmothers. And when I would go over their houses, they would always have cakes and cookies available. Baking with my grandparents, you know, again, moving forward to my parents, you know, cooking, baking.
It's in the blood.
It's in the blood. And it's always just a great thing for actually around this time of the year for festivities, you know.
So how much fruit?
Make some sweet.
Okay.
You can put that much on. That'd be fantastic.
Oh,
yeah, you can put like two or three pieces.
And rhubarb. I'm loving rhubarb.
The rhubarb is great.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can still find rhubarb, and you can only follow this for you.
Oh.
And you can still find peaches. These things that you actually sticks that you see in here, we actually get some fantastic lemon verbena.
That's in one of my moisturizers, by the way.
Say nothing. Nobody saw.
I think rhubarb too is it's such a great natural ingredient to use that you can't forget about.
Because you know what, it is also one of those things that you do need to use a fair amount of
watch out, Colleen.
Sugar.
He just dropped
sugar. Don't sugar and honey in there.
All right, you know what? We're gonna take over. So we're gonna build this one.
Gotta watch out for this guy over here. He's got a knife in his hand.
I know.
Are we adding some of this?
Yes, you can add a little bit of rhubarb to that.
Definitely put some of the juice. Specifically, that we have to do to are we marinating this?
Yes, it's been cooked in some orange juice, a little bit of sugar, some honey, a little bit of thyme, and a touch of salt.
Lovely.
That was all put together.
Salt. Yeah, I wouldn't think to do that.
Yeah, most people don't think that you put salt in pastries, but you really do need the salt to enhance.
Do you want more cream on top?
No, no. You know what? I think we should try this one. This is the one that's done.
Sure, absolutely.
And let's try this one because you got another sweet treat that you made for us, and we want you to tell us about that one.
Sure,
as well.
Absolutely.
We don't want to run out of time.
Yeah.
This pretty one.
Wink, wink.
It's so delicate. It's so delicate. So tell us about this one.
Yeah, this one's cutie patootie. So here I have three vanilla wafer cookies that we make at work.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I make everything at work like this is the only thing. Everything we do is from scratch. And then we put a little dollop of pastry cream on the bottom.
You're so good at the dollops.
Yeah, I have a thing for dollops.
I'm going to ask you, what is your favorite dessert? Being a pastry chef, I cannot imagine having to answer this question.
No,
so go for it.
You know, cheesecake.
Oh, you can't go wrong with a glass of cheesecake.
I'm a Jersey girl. I love old school Jersey diner cheesecake.
Oh yeah,
I really do. Sprinkle a little coconut on here. And then I'm actually gonna grab a banana over here.
Oh yeah, grab that banana.
So
here
this
we go.
Is kind of vanilla wafer banana action going on.
And okay. John's not talking. He's shoving corn cakes in his mouth.
John's totally checked out of this segment. Chef Colleen Graves, yes. Thank you so much for being here from the Red Cat Restaurant. And you're located at Chelsea at 227 10th Avenue and 23rd Street. And these recipes, I'm sure, will be on our website.
WYTV.com/thecouch.
Make sure you check it out.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much. Enjoy.
Yes, and now, you know what we've been asking today's Cue from the Couch? What's your favorite dessert? You know what? Yes. I think one of these is our favorite dessert. I can't wait to try that one. Here's what some of you are telling us online. Heather answered on Facebook. She says, baklava. I've only been able to, or lucky to enjoy this just once, but that one time was so delicious that it still makes it my most favorite dessert.
And it's got nuts in it, so it's got, protein. It's a health food.
It's health food.
Right. Creme brulee. First time I tasted it was in London. I've been a fan ever since. So yum, and a good one.
And Anne Marie says, cheesecake
Colleen. Perfect. Well, thank you again for bringing these sweet treats in. Now, they are the hottest thing in music with Preschool Set, the Fresh Beat.